As Richard was from a noble family, finding male line relatives was very straightforward to do. Using Burke's peerage allowed us to identify a number of people by going up from Richard to Edward III and then back down again through John of Gaunt, and that goes on through the Earls and Dukes of Somerset and eventually the Dukes of Beaufort. We traced 5 living male line descendants of Henry Somerset, the 5th Duke of Beaufort, who lived in the 18th century. I'm expecting that they should all have the same or similar Y chromosomes and that they should match the skeletal remains. Now, doing the Y chromosome work, I found that there wasn't a link between Richard III and the male line relatives who are alive today. Now, this doesn't mean that the skeleton isn't Richard, because what we have already is very strong evidence coming from all the other analysis and from the mitochondrial DNA. The genealogy tells us that they should be related, but the DNA is telling us that there has been a false or misattributed paternity, where the biological father is not the recorded father, somewhere in the 19 generations between Henry Somerset and Richard III. And that's broken the Y chromosome link. The majority of links in the chain, 13 out of the 19, do not affect royal descent at all. It's the remaining 6 links that could do. Breaks in the links on the Yorkist side of the tree could affect the claim to the throne of the Yorkist Plantagenet kings, Edward IV and Richard III. If the break occurs between Edward III and his son John of Gaunt, then this asks questions about the legitimacy of any of John's sons, including Henry IV and his subsequent heirs, Henry V and Henry VI. John's heirs also include Henry Tudor, who started the Tudor royal dynasty. He was descended from John of Gaunt's illegitimate son, John Beaufort, so a break there could also affect the Tudors' claim to the throne. At this moment in time, we have absolutely no proof as to where that break or breaks occurred. There are 19 links in that chain, 6 of which could affect royal descent. So statistically speaking, it's likely to have had no effect at all. However, it would be interesting to investigate this further to fully understand where that break occurred in the Y chromosome chain.